There's a huge amount of misinformation out there on the internet. It's a problem we've been working hard on at Facebook, and we're committed to fighting it. After all, people want to see accurate information, and so do we. I'm Dan Zigman, Director of Analytics for Newsfeed, and a lot of people ask me, how's it going? We're happy to report that once a piece of false news goes through our process, we're able to reduce its distribution on Facebook by 80%. How does this work? We listen to feedback from our community, and we use machine learning to understand what stories might be false. Then we send those potential hoaxes to our fact-checking partners for review. These organizations review the stories, check their facts, and rate their accuracy. When a fact-checker rates a story as false, we show the story lower in newsfeed, significantly reducing its distribution. This is the most important part of the process. This stops the hoax from spreading and reduces the number of people who see it. When false news does appear in people's newsfeed, we give people more information about the story. If fact-checkers write articles debunking a false news story, we show it in related articles immediately beneath it. If someone tries to post or share a story that's been determined by fact-checkers to be false, we let them know, since nobody wants to unwittingly share false news. We also take action against domains and pages that repeatedly create false news. Repeat offenders will see their ability to advertise removed, their distribution reduced, and their opportunities to monetize restricted. We found that a lot of false news is financially motivated. Spammers and scammers make money by masquerading as legitimate news publishers and posting hoaxes that get people to visit their sites, which are often mostly ads. By reducing the distribution that their hoaxes get in newsfeed, we're making it harder for them to make money. So, what's next? Although our current process can reduce the distribution of false news by 80% once it's identified, we aren't stopping there, and we know the process takes too long. It commonly takes over 3 days for fact checkers to provide their rating, and we know most impressions typically happen in that initial time period. That's just not good enough. So we're working hard now to accelerate this process. We've made great progress, but we still have a lot of work to do. We're all really committed to fighting false news on Facebook. It's what I do every day.